But tonight, then we saw John Moore and Roddy Robertson do the Radisson. And my pal H's young boy, young Roddy, up for an award. So come on, the Blue Veil, you can do it. Okay. Well deserved, young Roddy boy. Good one. So just come on to the Radisson. Yes, is it a drink? A drink on arrival. There you go. So a wee drink, thank you. That's fun. Thank you. So there you go, a wee drink on arrival. Say cheers, Gary. Cheers, Ashley. Besides in the Radisson here. I bet there's Mr. Boo there. Would you like to say hello on the cameras today? So there we go. Is everybody in tonight? That looks quite good in here, doesn't it? It's going to be a good night. Hopefully young Brody will get the award tonight for Blue Veil. Well, I've watched Brody's progress. He used to train with Mean H. What a wee machine he is. You know what I mean? Brilliant. But, everybody coming in tonight. Yeah. That'll do just now. Gary's standing there saying, look, you need to hold this track. How'd you do? Paid the ticket. Thank you very much. Thank you. So there we go there. And this is your son tonight, isn't it?
Yes, how you doing?
Yes, good. What club does he box for?
Nightmare,
brilliant. Club. What age is he?
He's 16.
And he's up for a couple of awards tonight,
he's up for three, aye.
He's up for three, brilliant. Where has he just come from?
Well, Cambuslang.
It's not a bad place, know what I mean? A lot of people from halfway and all of that. So we'll go over, is that your mother there? Yeah, you say hello. it looks as if it's going to be a fantastic night, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah, I'm looking forward
to it. No, definitely. I hope he wins. We'll go and speak to him now then. How you doing, young man?
Yeah, I'm good.
So what's your name?
Taylor McMahon.
Taylor. When did you start boxing, Taylor?
Yeah, I was 9 years old.
Nine? Brilliant. I wish I'd have done it. I'm a cunty fighter. You know what I mean? So where did you start off?
I started at News ABC. Then I just recently moved to Nightmare Boxing Club.
Right.
I box for Scotland as well.
Oh, you box for Scotland? Brilliant. No, brilliant. What age did you just turn 16?
I'm turning 17 in November, so I'm 16-year-old.
So you're still amateur, I take it then, aye. So how many times a week do you train in that?
Well, I know it's 5 times and it's usually 2.
So you're right dedicated then in that, aye. Many times do you go to the boxing club to do that?
3 times a week at the club and then I'm training.
Brilliant. Have you left school now?
I've left school.
Oh, that's brilliant. That's brilliant. So, many awards did you see? You're up for three?
I'm up for three, man.
I was speaking to your mother, and is that your granny there?
Yeah.
Proud parent. The dad in the corner, he's a bit shamrock. But I've got him in, you know what I mean? No, listen, I wish you all the luck, because me and my brother and girlfriend are actually here. Beautiful, my pal Harry's wee boy, young Brody. I think he's 11, 12. Do you know Brody?
He's
up for a award for the Blue Veil. But it looks a fantastic setting and all that tonight, doesn't it? No, that's good. I like to see somebody doing good in their life, because me, I haven't done that rank, pub. I should have gotten into all that, but that's it. You know what I mean? No, but fantastic, and I'll shake your hand. And hope you win. I'll give you a big cheer anyway. And there's the mother again, and the grand, they're in there. Looking very glamorous tonight, mother. And the mother as well.
This is Erin, this is Taylor.
Is it okay to video Erin? Erin, how are you?
I'm good.
How long have you been getting out?
Nearly 3 years.
3 years? You're looking very elegant as well, I must say. Looking good. No, he's doing well. I hope he gets an award, you know what I mean? And lovely to see you on the family. And who's the young one there?
Oh, it's my daughter Harper. She's nice.
Harper, what a lovely name. Is that no David Beckham's daughter's name? Harper. What age are you, Harper?
Nine.
Nine? Brilliant. I've got a wee girl that's just started school. Millie, she's five.
For friend, for keeping us standing at the end, but most of all, Lord, at the bell, keep the boxers safe and well. Amen. Enjoy your meal. We'll see you soon.
Gary, a shy man is up. What do you think of the soup so far, Gary?
That's lovely.
It is, Gary, but do you know what? Me and you are programmed to eat anything. And what about you, Mr. Lynch? What do you think of the soup so far?
Absolutely beautiful.
Nice, yeah. Gary, it's a bit. We're sitting at the table ourselves with two friends that was to come tonight. And never came, unfortunately, but we're having a great night. And Gary's really enjoying himself tonight. Hey, Gary. Gary's very smart tonight. Would you like to say a few words?
There was going to be five free bottles of wine.
Yeah,
let's
just show the viewers this, Gary, all the wine and all that. But Ian's had a lager so far. And he said one of the free complimentary Prosecco. I don't know if it was champagne. But Gary's really enjoying it. Gary works hard, you know what I mean? And he's got away early today for this. And me, him and H go back a long way, don't we?
Certainly do.
And it's good to see H's a boy up, young Brody. And we're here to support the Blue Vale, aren't we?
Yeah, that's why we're here, Ian.
But saying that, I was never speaking to the mob for Canvas Lang. They're all great people. And I hope that boy wins an award as well, you know what I mean?
As long as young Brody comes first.
That'd be great for the Blue Vale, know what I mean? But just to even be recognised, it's really good. And me and Gary have came in the suits tonight. I know you see me running about like a tramp between the tracksuit and all that on. But we were in Sir John Moo there earlier, and we're going to have a great night. What do you think, Gary?
Yeah, going to be a fantastic night.
Okay, Mr. McDonald, thank you for your candidness and the soup, and let's home in this wine again.
Right.
And there we go, Mr. Rixey. So, how you doing, Mr. Alexander? Would you like to be in video here on the blink? You'll miss it.
They are great. Do you want to give a wee talk, Jamie?
No, Jamie's a good friend. I met Jamie up in the Savoy Centre when he had his shop and all that. He's doing fantastic, and I met him at Stirling last year as well, Jamie. Would you just like to say a few words? You're putting on a great show, mate.
Aye, thanks for your support, even in my show, putting out my award. I'm going to get you presenting the award, so maybe you can add something.
Are you? It's okay, really. You're going to do that?
Just be swearing when you're up that stage.
I'm on a gyro, Jamie. I've just managed to get the ticket. But this is Gary, my brother here. Jamie. Gary, this is Jamie, who's organised it all. He used to have a shop in the Savoy. No, but Jamie, you've done brilliant. And me and Gary actually bought another couple of tickets for two friends, and they've not appeared. So there's me, the girlfriend, and we're here to support young Brody Dow for the Blue Vale. And he's up for a few awards, but is it no fantastic in here, Jamie? So what are you up to? These are apart from doing all these big events.
Welfare advice, and you're fucking Kingsbury Flats and going
right.
Some of my colleagues are here, but
right.
Other than that, it's just the
box. Have you not got a shop with that? I've been in the shop. Somebody else in there. But I was in Jamie's shop many a time, you know what I mean? And he's a good guy. And Jamie, you do a lot for all the youth and all that. You do put a lot of work in, mate. It's no easy, you know what I mean? And look at it in here tonight, it's fantastic, you know what I mean? And so, few awards at start of nine. We're going to get this dinner, Jamie boy. And it's great to see you, mate. Thank you, Jamie. Right, cheers.
Ian, I think it'd be a good idea to put water in Ashley's wine. More.
Keep going. More?
Aye, keep going.
More, Gary?
Yeah, because that wine's 12%.
Remember, this is the second glass.
Right, that should be enough. Okay. Hopefully she falls for it.
Well, we'll soon see. Let's taste it to see.
I'm very well. My name's Craig Stephen and I'm a boxing ring announcer, but tonight I am the compere at JATV Scottish Boxer of the Year Awards. And hey ho, I'm up for an award for ring announcer of the year. And I'll tell you what, see if I don't win it, I'm dropping the mic and I'm going home. So
I love your confidence.
You'll see loads of video from this good gentleman here. And next year when the awards come along, make sure you get a ticket and come along and sit at Mr. McDonald's.
I know Jamie. Jamie's done brilliant, know what I mean?
Jamie's done very, very well.
And yourself and all that, you're up. So, no, it's all for a good cause.
It is for a good cause, and it celebrates not only professional boxing, but it celebrates the Olympic-style boxing. Yeah. Amateur boxing, we used to call it. We don't call it amateur anymore. We call it Olympic-style boxing. These guys aren't paid to box.
That's right.
I'm not allowed to call them fighters, because fighting happens outside the pub on a Friday night.
That's right.
This is boxing.
I used to be involved in that myself many years ago.
Yeah.
So I'm actually here to represent my friend, Harry Dowes, young boy Brody from Bluevale.
Right.
He's
right.
Up for an award tonight. He's only 12.
Yes. Yes.
So that's actually the girlfriend, my brother Gary. So we've came, and by the way, what a fantastic venue! And so far we've really enjoyed it.
Well, this is the home of Scottish boxing. This is the home.
It's
of
a big night tonight, isn't it?
51-year-old St Andrews Sporting Club.
Oh, is it? Aye. And who was the guy that used to run that sporting club? The
Tommy
promoter.
Tommy Gilmer.
Is Tommy still with us?
Tommy's
done a lot over the years. It used to have it in the, was it the Marriott?
The Albany. And we came here temporarily
right.
because we're going to rebuild the Albany.
Right.
But they never rebuilt the Albany.
It was a good famous venue for Glasgow. I remember growing up listening to Tommy Gilmer's events and cracking guy. Same as Big Alec Morrison.
Yes, they're both still with us.
Big Alec, I went to his gym 40 years ago with our boy John Stark.
Right.
I was a shitty boxer.
I
tried to be wide and John just went boom and took the solar plexus away.
Well, you know, boxers know what they're doing.
But Alec's fantastic, you know, he's done a lot, you know what I mean? And Tommy Gilmer as well, and yourself as well.
Oh, thank you.
Right, I hope you win tonight.
Love doing it. Thank you very much.
And thank you for your
good
time.
To meet you.
And, right, okay.
Thanks to everybody out there watching.
No, they're brilliant. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Gentlemen. Bye. On you go now. Right, I'm putting this back in the thing so Ashley doesn't say no. One. And that one's already fucking full. So Ashley, you'll see this when the video comes out. Just water the drink down. Nice one, Gary. Good team.
I managed to get myself a plate of the main course. Was that not a fantastic dinner? Please, the appreciation of the head chef and all the waiting staff here at the Radisson Blue Hotel. So ladies and gentlemen, just a couple of moments. We're going to sort ourselves out. We're going to put a wee bit of music on and we will get on with the awards in less than 3 minutes. Three and nine. 39. Actually, there's only one of you doing it. Eight and three. 83. We're down to three people. What's it?
Fan. You're in the 60 club now, aren't you?
I'm in the 60 club now, yeah. I was born in Shettleston. I believe you know that. A few people from Shettleston. No far from the Town Tavern, a place called McNair Street.
Mm-hmm. Town Tavern in Shettleston, a big chick tinny, just to get with a girl in there.
Well,
in Shettleston Road.
He's actually a very good friend of mine, now gone, that I was brought up with. I believe it was Michael Healy.
Mick, aye. Mick was a legend.
Him and his da.
Right.
Mum Jemima.
Right. So you brought up all of them? Because they were in Rickasey and they moved into Shettleston,
yes,
really?
That's correct. They stayed in Shettleston and old Grander Healy, he used to stay above the pub where Joe Bananas was found.
The cottage
bar.
Right. So Gillis, so were you brought up in Shettleston or Rickasey?
No, I was born in Shettleston.
Born in Shettleston.
And
would you like to just tell the viewers that you've got a twin, Alan? I'm fond of his twin, Alan.
Yes, I've got a twin.
Alan's a good guy.
When we were younger age, we used to get called the Cray Twins.
You like the Cray Twins?
Reggie and Ronnie, yeah. We used to go to Cranhall Secondary.
Right. Did you know John McCaffrey, a good friend of mine, Calf? He's sadly no with us.
Yes, I
Calf died Calf. 7 years ago. We always think about him.
That's
great.
Ian keeps talking to Gary here and he's talking about.
Yes, this is Ian's brother, Gary.
We'll get Gary in there. Gary, you know young Gillis and Alan?
Good mates.
Good guy, isn't he?
Yeah,
good guy.
People.
But it's all about young Gillis, is it? So your wee ma, was she no well the other year as well?
She was, she's worked all her days and then she took a nervous breakdown round about the 70s, mid-80s. Her name was Matilda, Tilly we called her.
Right.
But unfortunately, sadly, she passed away. Very sadly missed, as I was a mammy's boy. She died of heart failure in April last year.
Was it last year? I remember you were saying that, and I said to him, my wee ma died 7 years ago, and I was like, your wee ma, you never replace your ma, do you, Gillis?
I know I'm 60 years of age, but...
You've joined the 60 club?
Yeah, people say, a mammy's boy, but the mammy's always your mammy.
You never get another mammy, didn't you, Gillis?
No.
So how's Big Alan doing? Let's talk to Big Alan.
Big Alan, he's...
doing well. He's not here tonight, unfortunately.
Not here tonight. He's had to stay at home, look after the premises.
And can we talk about the main man tonight, young Brody? You've watched young Brody if he was born rising.
Yes.
To his career. Would you like to say a few words about young Brody?
Well, young Brody, amateur boxer, very good boxer. Hopefully he's going to win the award tonight.
Here, here.
He's been the Scottish 12-year-old. Champion, schoolboys champion, he won the Golden Globes.
Brilliant.
He's also won quite a few of his events. Very good, very talented boxer. I would say that he's got a brother called Darryl who coaches him quite a lot.
Oh, there we go. There's another man coming into the frame here. How are you doing? I'll just talk to you and girls, right? Introduce yourself tonight.
Alright.
Who are you here to represent tonight?
Brody.
Young Brody.
Young Brody.
We're all here for young Brody tonight. It's good to see you, my friend.
Good to see
this
you
is
too.
My brother Gary here.
Good to see you, Gary.
It's Gary there. He's a good man. This man here. Just like to just say a few words about yourself.
I don't need to say nothing.
That's a good
one.
No, it's good to see you here tonight. You know what I mean? And we hope young Brody's going to get it tonight. He's trained hard, didn't he?
He's very hard.
My good friend, Gillis, we just had a nice interview there.
For a buff.
Yes, that's good. That's good. There you go. So, well, we'll just finish up there. It's been a pleasure, as always, my good friend.
Also a pleasure to meet you, Ian.
Yes, and we've been good friends for all the years then. To the H boy and that. So nice one. And let's hope that the young Brody gets up there and gets the stage. Thank you.
However, ladies and gentlemen, the boxing family also faced tragedy this year as we lost two boxers long, long before their time. 3 months ago, a motorcycle accident took the life of 28-year-old Andy Tam, Scottish featherweight champion, phenomenal amateur, now doing things in the pros. And in April, aged only 45, we lost a man whose boxing resume speaks volumes. Garthamwat man, proud Glaswegian, Willie Lemond. Both boxers will be sadly missed, but they will be fondly, fondly remembered for many years to come. We take a moment, ladies and gentlemen, in respect of the memory of Andy Tam and Willie Lemond. And Jamie, I've... No, I haven't. I found them. Yeah, I'll
awful wee podium here, but a lot of stuff to put on it. Media Award recognises the positive impact that the media has played on our boxing community by celebrating a news article, a podcast, or any other form of media which has promoted boxing in a positive light. The nominees are Archie Dury Speaks, JATV Raw Series. Vera Chloe Zabroska, photography at the all-female boxing show. Frank Gilfeather, for just being Frank Gilfeather. Barhead news article by Julian McPherson, teenager star represents Boxing Scotland and wins gold. And finally, by no means least, the very talented photographer, Dean Cohen. Here to present the award, would you welcome onto the stage, Tamsin Quigley. Gentlemen, I never thought I'd hear myself say this. Could we hear Archie Dury speak?
Well, that's very much people are voting for next happy. As you know, social media, I'm never off it. I'm all day going solid. So as I did this week especially, I've caused a lot of shamanical day, if you like. So I have, right? But things I gave my boxer, I gave my club, I gave my kids, that's what I did. The decisions I make is for them, first and foremost, for the end. Anybody knows Archie Dury, knows that's what I did. I might be loud at the shows, maybe we can shout and bawl and different things, all the rest of it. Things that I did, I started buying my kids, it's for my kids to make up. And obviously, social media is a hero world that I would, but this time, right, again, what I've wrote today, I've left the Alliance and got back to Boxing Scotland. I made a lot of enemies again, if you like, right? But I want to get involved in social media, other people and saying things bad and other people. It's for the kids, and I'm not going to get involved. And thank you, Mr. Lord, right? Thank you, Lord.
So, Mr. Ian Wilson, the El Supremo of the St. Andrews Sporting Club.
Well, thanks very much, everybody. It's a real privilege and honour to get this. It was a huge night for Scottish boxing, and it's quite hard to believe that two of the main events, one being World of Women, a really good friend of mine, and Andy Tan, his family's all here as well, that won the Scottish title that night, and they will never be forgotten about St. Andrews, but that means a lot, so thank you.
Thank you to
Anna Armstrong couldn't actually be here tonight because she's unfortunately really unwell, but we're representing her on behalf of Dunhamer and the Western District All Female Show. So thank you so much, everyone.
Our boxing community, and this is our opportunity to say thank you to the backbone of Scottish boxing. Our nominations are from Southside Boxing Academy, Antonia Quayle. From Lockheed Boxing in Dundee, Heather Brown.
from Jones's Boxing in the village of Clean Stirling, Joanne Casey. From St Francis in Dundee, Mr. Norrie McVicker. From the Beef Boxing Club, Sonia Stewart. From the club that gave me my second ever boxing show way back over 20 years ago, Cloven Stone in Edinburgh, Stuart Buchanan. And from the McTaggart Scott Boxing Club in Edinburgh, Tina Hutchinson. To present the award, please welcome onto the stage, Mr. Dylan Arbuckle. You missed that for the red walk tune.
winners, Tina Hutchison.
Crossan and Andrew Smart, the battle of the legends in Greyhead. Alfie Poole and Ben Bartlett, Kynard Boxing's last man standing. Only one Scotsman in the next one, there only has to be one Scotsman, Willie Hutchison against Craig Spider Richards. Queensbury versus Matchrooms 515. And on TNT Sports for Frank Warren, Nathaniel Collins against Francesco Grandelli. Ladies and gentlemen, to open the envelope, please welcome onto the stage, holder of the Lord Lonsdale Challenge belt, Akesha Farooq. Boxing. Mr. Danny Scullion. And he's not coming, he's sending someone else in his stead.
coach is only as good as the boxers that you've had in the gym, and I wish you all the very best. Thank you.
Billy, before you go, I think everybody would like to join in. Billy has been singing the praises of Martin McCauley for many, many a year, and he has just been proved right for the big man. Did the business. What's next on the cards for Martin?
There was a lot of speculation that he was to fight Thilly Zhang, but like so many before him, he doesn't want to fight now, so we've been offered the Ajit Kabayan. And after this fight, tomorrow night, there'll be hopefully a fight with Kabayan to become the number one in the IBF. So when we beat him, we'll then be number one in the IBF and the WBA. And I look forward to a lot of great fights.
Billy, our best wishes for you and the big man. And you can always say that he's fought here in the Radisson at the St. Andrews Sporting Club. Please pass on our best. So, ladies and gentlemen, our next...
Bibby.
Well, it looks like a new season.
Where's the table with?
We move on to the National Development Awards.
Try to look for the table. We've actually been moved. Do you know where we've been moved to?
Our nominations are right from Glenn Roberts, Scott Singh, in the Kilo 5, Cameron Brown.
My table.
From Blue Vale, Denniston, Ali D. Hutchison, Martin McCauley, and Nathaniel Collins. To present the award, one of our sponsors from Electro Asset Services, please welcome Chris McVeigh. Tory Glen, Southside Boxing Academy and Community Hub. The quite recently formed Western District Team Training. And the Emmy Smiley Charity Foundation fundraiser, Airdrie to the Allianz Arena. To present the awards, would you please welcome veteran, referee, and huge supporter of Scottish boxing, Mr. Norrie McVicar.
Kainer Boxing Gym. Who's doing this? I'm hearing noises. Coliseum Boxing Gym. Forrester Boxing Fitness. The Rivals Gym up there in Wishaw. And three-weight world champion Ricky Burns, Mighty Ricks Boxing and Fitness. And to present this award, once again, the Danny Scullion table, because Danny's not going to come up. So somebody from the Danny Scullion table, please. So thanks to Jamie. We're going to get Jamie back up a wee bit later on. Thank you. Pierre Harvey's, Cameron Talbot, from the Bronx Trident, Rocco McDonald, and from the club that gave me my very first ever boxing show, yes, they are to blame for this, Rio Martin. To present the winner with his trophy, once again, can I ask up to the stage, Mr. Dylan Arbuckle.
So I think you're here for the right representing.
Anil's ABC Canvas Line, we've just won Best Club of the Year award at the awards over the moon. Can't help the communities with the day, and that's what we ever wanted to do. Time can't be bought.
Excuse me, I spoke to a family earlier, they've got a 16-year-old son, and he's got up for a couple of awards tonight. I forget his name. Do you know who I'm talking about for Canvas Line? There's a big table there sitting next to you, you know what I mean?
Taylor McMahon, box for the club, he lived in the club, right. Well.
So what do you do yourself?
I'm a coach.
You're a coach, right?
I'm a coach.
Oh, brilliant, mate.
I'm Andy Clayton, Brian
Murphy.
Right.
You're a boys there. Right. No, brilliant, mate. Take my hat off to you, you know what I mean?
What to represent for everybody. No. Volunteer work. Don't take a penny for it.
No, that's what I like.
You're not about to do something for
it. No, definitely. No.
Is Craig let anybody touch his microphone? So I'm honoured, Craig. I feels like a lightsaber. Before we go into the next few awards, first of all, just want to say a massive thank you to everybody that's turned out tonight. It has been a tough year, I think, for Scottish boxing, but for me personally, it's been a tough few weeks, and I'm just thankful to you guys, for the boxing community, the young people that I get to work with every week. KCC staff that's came to join us tonight just has my back when I'm not in the box and stuff. The next award is my nephew who's on the slide. That's the next slide, please. Not too far, that one. No. One more. There we go. So the first year we had the Young Champion Award, and it was we named it after Cash Farouk. Last year we didn't have it. We only have it when we think there's been a young boxer who's excelled, not just in the boxing ring. It's called the Young Champion of Boxing, but it's somebody that champions a cause by using their connections within boxing. This year, I thought it was going easy. This year, Craig mentioned earlier, we lost Andy Tam in a tragic motorcycle accident. 2 weeks ago, I lost one of my best mates in Italy in similar circumstances. So. So the winner of the Public Choice Scottish Boxer of the Year Award 2024 is Cameron the Tank Talbot. Since I'm up the stage, Cameron is a proud member of the Keir Harvey riot crew. Invades every interview I do that involves somebody for Keir Harvey. My man, first of all, right, because I've not seen your ages, how you doing? What have we got coming up?
Jay
Sheridan, South Side. Oh, you've got Jay Sheridan?
Yeah.
Who's going to win that?
Me.
matches. I know all these boxers, and I think the Royal boxers, especially the internationals, have all been like new boxers. I am going for Rob Roy.
Say something. No, the criteria, but for anybody who doesn't, and if this is being recorded, if maybe this little bit could go out. Although JATV is behind the awards, Jamie does not do the nominations, as we saw with the professional female. The nominations come in from the public, and Jamie is not one of the judges. So I know for a fact that Jamie gets an unreasonable amount of shit from a few people, invariably parents, over selection and over who wins. Yeah, yeah. It's nothing to do with it. Okay. But it isn't. So let's move on to...
So this is us coming out tonight. Unfortunately, young Brody never won the award. So there's Gary and Ashley there.
What a night it's been.
So yes, it has been. So Gary, would you like to just finish off and say about the night? What did you think of the night?
I was here at the box.
Did you enjoy it?
Yes.
And we've come out a reasonable hour. It's before 11 o'clock.
We have a good friend. And
he met Cuts, Jim Aitken, etc. Yeah. Harry, of course, started tonight in the Sir John Muir. And we've come out at a respectable time, 10:45, me, Gary and Ashley, and my good friend Harry, that they're all away. Unfortunately, young Brody even never won it, but he's only 12, he's up and coming, over commiserated, but what a fantastic night. And Jamie Alexander, no, my pal Jamie at the pub, Jamie Fijab TV, you done brilliant, mate. The food was excellent. Everybody was excellent, and what a fantastic night. So you're a credit, Jamie. You do a lot of work goes into this, mate. And I'd like to say thank you, Jamie, to everybody in Glasgow. You put on a great show. I've interviewed a few people. So bye from me, and goodbye for Glasgow. Cheers, Jamie.